tonight. songs this evening?
We'll be right back.
that's always around. We'll be right back. sight. But as the longing on into the light, we'll be right back.
Thank you so very much. Happy birthday wish to Brian Marlowe. Thank you.
Thank you.
Something with the beat. I'd like to send one out to Sunshine and Atomic Bitch Wax, who were fat this evening. Thank you for enjoying yourselves. We'll be right back.
They're really big into them. It's all the seaweed. Yeah, they're still.
Yeah. Thank you. a couple more left for you to bring out the clutch. This one's called Birth to the Earth. So this one's going out there. We'll be right back.
Nationals, and we're about to find out who the Knoxville champion's gonna be, guys.
Danny the Dude Lasoski on the front row alongside of Mark Kinzer. Steve Evans, what do you think?
There was an interesting waiting game down here. No one seemed to want to leave their pits first to bump start and start warming up their engines. And I think that's because they didn't want to reveal what rear tire they were using. As soon as they put it on, everybody would know what rubber they have chosen, and rubber's going to mean a lot.
It is going to be the game. You're right, Steve. And look at that big cube back there in the 11th position. I was talking to a couple of the drivers earlier on. I said, how far back do you have to go before Kinzer's out of it? Steve, of course, I'm talking about. They said, the E main, maybe. He's already 11th in the A. He's well in this one if you're a Kinzer fan.
But it's only been one time this race, only one time from that far back. And that was all the way back in 1962.
Well, if you're watching on TNN, I'm sure your adrenaline's pumping like ours. The 35th Amoco Knoxville Nationals is live.
Sammy Swindell put his left front wheel right through the infield.
Kinzer's got the lead. Mark Kinzer puts the working entry into the front spot, and Lasoski follows up.
Sammy in trouble on the backstretch.
You see Andy Hillenberg inside. But there's your problem. Guy Forbrick's car, that's Johnny Herrera and Craig Delansky with big problems. There's two other cars involved out there. And I can't see it from here. And Sammy Swindell's got a big problem.
We've got a red flag on the racetrack. All the cars are going into the pit area now.
Looks like Steve Beitler has got a big problem and the 94 of Dale Blaney. Now, that does not necessarily mean these guys are done. If it's just a flat tire or something that can be repaired quickly, they'll have the chance to do that. Let's take a look at it. Watch it about the back of the pack.
Well, right up front, Sammy Swindell's already had a problem. He got into the fence hard. You can see his car, that's the orange car, turning round and round, and he is kind of a, oh, wow, look at Delansky going side over side in that number 55 automobile.
That's Herrera in the middle. They both hit that car. Here you see, look at Kinzer up on the top on the inside as we watch Delansky go flying.
What a ride he took.
Look at the tire coming off and it goes right over Steve Kinzer. There's another look at it. There's the Herrera car with Delansky coming right through him.
He just goes right over the top of Herrera's tires, and there he goes, barrel rolling through the corner.
We talked about Andy Hillenberg's luck changing here in Knoxville. He slid through without getting any damage. There goes Stevie Smith. Look at the tire going over Steve Kinzer.
Steve Kinzer's got so much luck here at Knoxville.
There is Lee Brewer's car that's involved in this as well. We had missed that one earlier on. And there's Sammy. Let's go down to Steve Evans. He's in the middle of it. What do you think, Steve?
Well, I'm a little surprised. I thought that Sammy Swindell had avoided any contact or any problems out there, but no, the Hooters car has a broken left shock. You can see the mount knocked right off it. The Gambler chassis guys, his own crew, are in here hopefully to fix that, but I don't know. You can see it is flat broken. It's not bent. What do you think, guys? Can you make it?
We're going to try to. That's all we can say.
Not going to bother them anymore, obviously.
Sammy Swindell, the 1981 and 82 World of Outlaws champion. Been here 22 times, and he's won it once. There you see, slamming Sammy.
It's Tommy Sanders working on that left front. He's from the chassis company from Gambler that builds those race cars for Sammy Swindell.
When we come back, well, let's get down to Bobby Jarrell.
An update on Craig Delansky as the 77 car rolls through. Craig Delansky's car obviously battered sitting in the middle of turn three. He's not going to be able to continue, obviously. The good news is that Craig Delansky is okay. He has walked away from this nasty one in turn number three, Ralph.
That's a real shame, too, Bob, because Delansky had motor problems earlier this season. And I talked to him during the week, and he felt that they'd gotten everything straightened out. He had the best chance here in the Knoxville Nationals. Instead, he's got a beat-up, battered-up race car. The A-Main still to go when we come back.
Out. As a special salute to the first live World of Outlaws race here on TNN, we've put together exclusive World of Outlaws collectibles as a special TV offer for tonight only. You get this dynamite World of Outlaws heavy cotton t-shirt, a high-quality cap, and the official race program autographed by the winner of tonight's race. A $70 value, yours tonight only, just $49.99. To order, have your credit card ready and call 1-800-3-OUTLAW. But hurry, it's a one-time offer and supplies won't last. So call now.
You probably think paint is paint. Well, one place has highly trained people who go to great lengths to answer any question, big or small. Expert color matching from the palest peach to the deepest pine green. And over 2,000 stores, so one's right in your neighborhood. Sherwin-Williams. And you thought it was just a can of paint. Hey, there's only one paint like ours and only one place to get it.
Sherwin-Williams. Now, Weather Perfect Flat is just $11.99 a gallon during our cool summer sale.
I learned to change oil with my dad out in the driveway when I was little. We always went to Walmart for just about anything. I buy my oil by the case at Walmart. I buy Quaker State. I use 10W30 in the winter and 10W40 in the summer. I have a drain pan that the oil goes right into. I put the lid on and take it back to Walmart. It's real easy. They recycle it for me. My husband bought me some ramps for Christmas so that I would change his oil when I change my oil. Change his oil? He must be kidding.
Hey, I'm Dave Blaney, and that's me racing the number 10 sprint car for Vibrant Alertness. Of course, I'm not always moving 150 miles an hour. Sometimes when I'm off the track, my busy schedule leaves me feeling drowsy, fatigued, like I'm stuck in first gear. That's when I revive. With Vibrant, it's a safe way to kick out of slow motion and get yourself moving again. And with about the same amount of caffeine as 2 cups of coffee, you know Vibrant's safe. So when you're feeling drowsy, take it from me, Dave Blaney. Just shift gear. Revive with Vibrant.
That's Lee Brewer's number 15 you're looking at as his crew goes to work on that. If you're wondering about changing a tire, you can do it. But if you do it under one of these red flag conditions, you go to the back of the
pack. You can do anything else you want to the car, but you can't change the
tire. Here's a real-time replay of this from inside Andy Hillenburg. Watch and listen. Did you see Hillenburg just duck his head?
Yeah, he didn't want to get hit by any tires or race cars or anything else.
You'll be amazed what can get through those cages. Let's get down to Bob Gerald.
Well, we're down here by the Dale Blaney car right now that has a broken tie rod. Dale is the all-star point leader, a 10-time feature winner this season. Dale, you think you'll be able to get your car repaired in time to go back racing?
I hope so. We just got a couple minor adjustments. So, yeah, it looks like we hopefully will.
A pretty wild incident on the back straightaway. Your impressions of what happened?
Well, I really couldn't see that much in front of me there. You know, I had two or three cars right in my line, and they just all got bottled up and stopped, and I hit a guy in rear end, and it kind of half spun me around, and I got tagged a couple more times, but I couldn't tell what happened.
Let's go to Steve.
Well, the Angel of Mercy is here, the Pro Torch welder. Don't look at that too long, folks. In fact, it might even hurt the camera. They're having to put a little tube there to attach the bracket for that left front shock. Sammy Swindell is crawling back in the car. Sammy, real quick, tell me what happened.
I don't know, Herrera stopped, and I didn't have any place to go.
So you did make contact?
Well, I went over his right rear. You usually don't expect somebody to stop in the middle of the straight.
No brake lights on sprint cars.
Now, the only light going on down there is the one that's coming from the welding torch as they try to get Sammy Swindell back together. And this guy is not a regular crew member. This is just the best guy in Knoxville is hanging around the racetrack with a welding torch.
Well, they need a welder to take that car back together again for sure. That's a bracket that holds the entire left front suspension on the car. That's not just a shock absorber, it's a coilover shock absorber that holds the car up.
One of the most important people here at the racetrack is, of course, Doug Clark, the starter. He is an integral role. There's Doug high above. We took a look at what Doug Clark is all about.
You guys have to be side by side, nose to tail. If you guys are running like, you know, side by side and somebody jumps up high like that, and I wave that green flag and you're hanging out there, or you're down in the middle or down on the bottom, that's going to be a jump. you're going to get penalized. First time you go to the back, second time you go to the pit. And let me tell you, if you guys go to the back, we watch you even closer because we know what you're going to be trying to do.
You seem to rule with a pretty sturdy but fair hand. How do you decide what is and what isn't fair?
I don't know, really. It's one of those things where you just have to, it's a judgment type of call deal where you just have to pay attention and see how the guys are doing. If they're, you know, going with the flow of the tempo, I'll kind of go with their flow. They'll kind of set the tempo, but I'll be the enforcer type of thing.
We know what Doug Clark thinks of the racers. We thought it'd be kind of interesting to find out what the racers think of Doug Clark.
Well, off the track, Doug's a good friend of mine. He's probably one of the nicest guys I've ever met in my life. As soon as he gets those flags in his hand, he's a real tough competitor himself. He expects good starts. He'll send you to the back for a bad start. And believe me, I know that. I've been sent back here several times.
I think he's one of the best flagmen I've ever raced under. And I've been track champion here 6 times, and he don't hesitate a bit to send me to the back.
Well, the main thing I like is he doesn't pull any punches with anybody. You know right ahead of time what you're up against, and if you foul up, there's no sense in blaming him because he explains to you real well what's going to happen. And that's what I really like. Yeah, that way you know going into the show, you know what to expect.
There is Doug Clark. Hey, Doug, big thumbs up. One of the nicest people you'd ever meet in racing, and he really...